When I made my second version of the Simplicity, or the variant, my clock face and the base and the pendulum and the bob and everything is made out of red oak. And then the gears, including the two wind-up gears, were all originally Baltic birch. And personally, I didn't like that white gear against this wood. I wanted to try and make them all the same color. And there you have a problem trying to find a piece of plywood, quarter inch, half inch, that's good quality plywood, flat, and is going to be the same color as the wood that you're using. So that's how I got into this process of trying to make my own plywood. Here you can see everything is made out of the same batch of red oak. Everything has the same type of appearance. The only difference here is that the face and the frame and the pendulum and the bob and everything, the hands have been given a coat of linseed oil. The gears and that are still just raw wood and will remain that color. But the color is much more the same, and I like this a lot better for this particular clock. The reason for wanting plywood for the gears is that hopefully it'll be more stable. If you take a piece of wood and these, the intermediate and the hour hand wheels, these happen to be made out of a piece of quarter sawn oak. This is just a straight, started off with a 5/16 and milled it down to quarter. Quarter sawn is pretty stable, and I hope that they will remain flat and not warp. So far they've worked out very well. The escape wheel I made out of 10 36 degree wedges and glued them together and then put the pattern on there and cut that out. So that's just a piece of quarter inch wood. The third wheel and the center wheel are plywood, and my two winding gears are, that's just half inch wood, half inch oak. This is my escape wheel. It's made out of 10 36 degree wedges glued together, and then I put the pattern on there and cut out all the holes in the teeth. All of my teeth in the clock are cut out on a scroll saw. This was my first attempt at making plywood. This is 2-ply. Since then, I've learned that you should always have an odd number of plies and maintain grain direction and symmetry on your on both outside plies. This one, I think you can see it's bowed and it's bent. Looks like a bicycle that ran into a curb. But on the clock, this thing ran very true and it kept very good time. I was surprised. It ran good. My only objection to it is that I knew it was bent and bowed, so that's why we got into this process of making the approximately quarter inch thick 5-ply plywood.